into session. Roll call of the members for the acting secretary, Jim Barnes.
You got a list?
No, sir, I don't. Look at your minutes for the roll call of the meeting from the September 16th.
All right, I'll just read that off. Okay, roll call. Major?
Here.
Barnes here. Briggs?
Here.
Darby? Gibson? Gray?
Yes.
Grissom?
Yes.
Jameson?
Here.
Mack?
Absent.
Shield?
Absent.
Truesdale?
Here.
Al Walters?
Here.
Greg Walters? With?
Here.
Okay. 6, 7, 8 present.
Thank you, Mr. Barnes. Approval of the agenda. I'd like to make an amendment to the agenda and add the treasurer's report following the approval of the minutes for the previous meetings. Is there a second or any discussion? Second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Briggs. Any discussion? There being none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Azure?
Yes.
Barnes, yes. Briggs?
Yes.
Darby, absent. Gray?
Yes.
Grissom?
Yes.
Jameson?
Yes.
Mack?
Absent.
Shield?
Absent.
Truesdale?
I'm going to abstain since I was not at those last two.
Abstain. Al Walters?
Here,
yes. Greg Walters?
Absent.
Whit?
Abstain.
Abstain. Okay.
Okay, approval of the minutes for the previous meetings. That would be September the 16th and September the 22nd. The chair has some questions on the minutes. On the 16th, the first question is approval and or amendment of the meeting agenda, add treasury report and discussion about the charter being on the ballot, placing the document on the city period. Word website needs to be added there. Second page, down toward the middle there, motion to ask city to put the charter document on the city webpage. Website was made by Greg Walters, seconded by Mr. Gray. And it notes that Mr. Gray voted no. I don't recall that, and it just doesn't strike me as correct that I would vote no after seconding it. Page 3. Page 3. Bids for Dan Estes is taking 3 bids for printing and mailing. If you go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines, the next sentence starts with, so the question about elected versus appointed ended up as question 2. Do you want the police chief elected? Yes. Do you want the police chief appointed? Yes. Is there any objection to that? And this is quoting me. What's missing from this section is the fact that I also read the change, which was to say, do you want a police chief that is choose 1, elected, box, appointed, box. So that needs to be changed. The printing and mailing of bids were presented by Chairman Gray, documentation with Gray. That documentation is with Mr. Estes. Treasurer's report. Discussion. Any reason a person on the city council should have expected legal fees? There's no attribution for that, and that was my comment. Okay, page 4, motion passes, and then reminder, you're going to have another meeting next Thursday at 5:30. That should be attributed to me. Then there's a motion to adjourn by Barnes, a second by Mack, with no opposition. The meeting adjourned at 5:50. Motion to adjourn was made by Chairman Gray at 6:15 with no objections. The meeting was adjourned. Well, it's got to be one or the other, so I would say strike the motion to adjourn was made by Barnes and Mack at 5:50. And leave, motion to adjourn was made by Chairman Gray at 6:15. Is there any further discussion of those minutes?
Mr. Chairman?
Mr. Ager.
I noticed another, some other things there. If you go back to page one, it shows that I arrived at 5:09. Actually, I got there about 5:07, and they were discussing that particular item. And when they called for a vote, I said, because I didn't even know what it was about, I will abstain. So I didn't vote on it because I didn't even know what the motion was. And I said that I don't know what the motion was, so I'll abstain. Please note also that it shows that I got there at, later it shows I got there at 5:05, and then also it shows I got there at 9:50.
I noticed that too.
So,
9:05, yeah.
Yeah, 9:05. So,
we didn't need that long, so that's a typo.
So, and I guess, and what I'm saying is that I walked in at, during, at the very end of the discussion on item number one, didn't know what it was about, I abstained, shows me absent for the next one, that's not correct, shows me absent for the third one. Please also notice that they didn't add those up correctly. That shows there that there are, seven and, if you count them up, it should be 7-2 rather than 8-1. Because it shows Gray voted no and Mac voted no. And I did vote on that.
All right, let's go, let's take this one at a time. Approval or amendment in placing the document on the city council website. Azure absent. Did you cast a vote?
For this number one, you mean the first item?
Yes.
I abstained.
Abstained. All right, that's a correction. Number two, motion to approve previous meetings, minutes. Azure.
I voted yes.
Voted yes. Okay. Public input, none. Motion to pay for transcription of previous meeting. Mr. Azure, vote.
No.
No. Mr. Azure, did you abstain on the motion? Did you abstain on the motion to ask the city to put the charter document on the
Yes, but go back to where they counted these things up also. If you need to count the yeses and noes, that should be actually, instead of 8-1, it should be 7-3. Okay. She counted 8-1, but there are two noes there.
That's fine.
Then if you go down the next one, the motion to ask the city charter, that was an abstain. It shows I'm there. And that should be, instead of 9-0, it says 9 yes, 0 no. Shows Mac voted no.
It should be 7-2-1, right?
Right.
Thank you. Any further corrections?
Yeah, we need to. Then, of course, strike down there where it says Asia joined the meeting at 9:05. And then when you go over to the next page, down at the bottom, it shows me absent again during the treasurer's report.
Okay.
And then you caught the other ones.
All right. Further discussion?
I think I voted yes for the treasurer's report. That makes it 10-0.
Mr. Chairman?
Thank you. 1 second. So, Azure wants to have his vote recorded as yes for a 10-0 vote for the treasurer. All right, thank you. Mr. Al Walters.
Mr. Chairman, who took these minutes?
Tracy Darby.
Well, she's not here, and I, outside of the questioning of the absent instead of abstain on changing votes here, it's kind of ungentlemanly, isn't it, to attack the record keeper who took all these records all this time.
Mr.
And this is the first time. Now we're questioning almost every vote. And I won't approve a change like that. I'll agree Mr. Asia was here. I'm not going to get into an argument over whether he arrived at 5:07 or 5:09. We don't have a time clock, so we can't settle that one. But I don't like that route of going this way. This is nitpicking to the extreme.
Well, it doesn't change the outcome of any of the votes.
That's what I mean.
Of any of the votes. It's not nitpicking in the sense that when I read this, I found these errors. And I would suspect that because she had to make these minutes back up later, because she was called out of town on business, that when she listened to the tapes, that she probably rushed through it. And nobody's nitpicking her or complaining about her or anything else.
We don't know that.
No, we don't know that because she's not here. And nobody's nitpicking her or criticizing her. I just want corrected minutes to reflect what I believe, at least from the airs I've
heard. I understand anybody can remember how they voted a month ago on stuff. I mean, you know, and we've got, here we have a written record, and here we've got somebody just saying it. It isn't a matter of what, I'm not questioning Mr. Acer in that respect, but why do we have a secretary to begin with? We could all sat down and said, well, wait a minute.
That's a side issue we're not going to digress into. Mr. Barnes.
Well, if people have additions or corrections to the minute, that's kind of what we're...
Yeah, that's just normal procedure here. Any no further comments? Mr. Greg Walters has joined the meeting at, I guess, 7:10?
It looks like 11 to me.
Whatever time you want to forget.
Looks like 11.
It was earlier than 7.
Oh, I just...
It was right here.
Ms. Whitman.
I have a question. Why have we allowed 1 month and then an additional week to have passed by without receiving these minutes? How do I know what I did or what I didn't do or what I said or what I didn't say after a month and a half?
The answer to that's very simple. You've got a volunteer, unpaid secretary who has done the best job she can do. So that criticism is not warranted in the chair's mind. Are there further discussions on correction of the minutes, Mr. Briggs?
The only thing I was going to point out to Ms. Whitman is that I think we're getting our minutes a lot quicker than the regular Board of Aldermen's getting theirs, and they have a paid staff person putting theirs out. So, you know, if you want to criticize your free help, I guess you can do that.
All right.
Can I make a comment? And I agree with Mr. Briggs. I think it's just a matter of courtesy, and when people get in a pinch, obviously they just can't do everything, and so if we don't get the minutes well in advance, I certainly understand that. I do think it's important, though, and I do want to go on record, that if indeed it is important enough to take minutes, that they ought to be at least correct. That's all. And we should have a chance to look them over ahead of time whenever possible. And just because the Board of Aldermen may not do it right all the time doesn't mean that it gives everybody else a license to do the same way, you know. So that's just the point I think that Mr. Whitman was making.
Well, I would notice, too, that I've asked the finance director for expenditure on a city outside legal fee to be answered within the 72-hour sunshine law requirements, and it's been a week and a half, and I still haven't heard. So it's a very imperfect world full of very imperfect people. I'd entertain a motion to either approve or reject these minutes of September the 16th.
As amended.
Corrected. Motion by Mr. Greg Walters, second by Mr. Jameson. Further discussion? There being none, roll call, Mr. Secretary.
Azier.
Yes.
Barnes, yes. Briggs.
Yes.
Darby, absent. Drake.
Mr. Secretary, please call me last on all votes. As we've been doing all along.
Grissom.
Yes.
Jameson.
Yes.
Mack. Shield. Truesdale.
Abstain.
Walters.
Al.
Abstain.
Greg Walters.
Yes.
Whitman.
Abstain.
Okay.
Gray, yes.
Gray.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, so.
Okay. September 22 minutes. Okay, I've read through these. I only have one question on them. That's on page 2. About two-thirds of the way down. Bids for mailing educational piece. These three bids were provided by fax phone to Dan Estes. Lee Gray has documentation. Lee Gray does not have the documentation. That's all been turned into Dan Estes. That's the only correction I have. Further discussion? Shirley Whitman.
Where's this neutral piece?
Oh, it's just here and there and everywhere in your city attorney's hands.
And no copy of said neutral piece was made available for the other commissioners to see?
I think that we're going to have that in our regular agenda. Right now, we're talking about voting on the minutes of September 22nd.
What about the documents being presented for signature and notarized?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I'm talking about the first thing on the agenda.
We're not talking about the agenda. We're discussing the minutes of September 22nd.
I mean to say the first thing on that we covered on the meeting of September the 22nd, that I walked into the meeting about 3 minutes late on. I'm asking what documents were presented. Did the people know what they were signing? Were there changes made? When I walk in, you're passing this document around for people to sign, and it was being notarized.
Right.
What were they signing? What had been changed?
They were signing the resolutions for a second time, per instructions from our attorney.
Why?
Because of typographical errors.
Because of typographical errors. No other changes were made at that time?
Would you like to feel that?
Go ahead.
Okay, ask again.
Did the people who were signing this, did they see what the typographical errors were that were being corrected and or changed?
To my knowledge, they were discussed and aware of them. The people
they
that
saw
the people that signed, signed. You chose not to sign the first time. So it's really not an issue with you, I wouldn't think. The rest of us signed, with the exception of you and Mr. Azier. Ms. Truesdale was absent. Ms. Mack chose not to sign. I don't know what Mrs. Truesdale's position on signing is one way or the other. Is there further discussion on these minutes?
You have a motion to approve.
No, sir.
You have now.
Thank you, Mr. Briggs. Second?
I'll second.
Greg Walters, second. Further discussion? There being, yes, Ms. Whitman.
I don't agree with the minutes as being presented.
That's
and
fine.
Therefore, I will not be approving it.
Well, I would suggest, is there any further discussion? There being none, roll call, please, Mr. Secretary.
Azier.
I will abstain. I wasn't present.
Barnes, yes. Briggs.
Yes.
Darby, absent. Gray, pass to Lynn. Grissom.
Yes.
Jameson.
Yes.
Mack, absent. Shield, absent. Truesdale.
Abstain.
Al Walters.
Yes.
Greg Walters.
Yes.
Whitman.
No.
No. Okay, you have 3 absences, 2 abstentions, 1 no, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then Mr. Gray.
Yes.
Thank you. So.
Motion carries. Treasurer's report, Mr. Al Walters.
Yes, sir. A few days ago, I requested from Dan Estes that I get a complete, codified, up-to-date report of all expenditures and payments made. I was informed by Mr. Estes that because these bills were subject to possible litigation, he could not authorize release of them. I tried to point out to him that any bill that comes in the city hall is subject to litigation if it doesn't get paid, but that didn't win, so we completed the proper form after discussion, and he did send me a copy this morning under the Missouri Sunshine Law. And everyone in here has one. Is there anyone who doesn't have one? You don't have one, would you like a financial report? Okay. So anyway, if you want to look at it, a lot of it is, I asked for the entire thing and we ran it front and back as a cost-saving measure. You can see all the breakdown of the attorney's time. At the very back, if I start from the back end, you'll see where there's notes on bills, like the production of the charter books. These bills have not been paid, is my understanding. And at the front is the bill from the legal firm for the charter. And showing due on that is about $26,000 right now. And this is, as we all know, in, well, the council, let's put it this way, have said don't pay the bill. So until this gets settled, the bills have not been paid. But I wanted to make sure everyone had this because there's been criticisms of the way we run it, that we've tried to hide things. It's not true. We had a financial report at all but two of the meetings, at all but two of them, and the only reason we didn't have them then was nothing had happened. I couldn't quite see the sense in producing a report that had nothing. That,
Mr. Walters?
Yes, sir.
What do you recall our liaison, who is also the finance director for the city of Raytown, saying to you during this process in regards to paying bills?
I was always told forward the bills to him.
Thank you.
Right. We never discussed, there's a lot of, been a lot of talk about what was budgeted, what was allotted, and this and that and the other. There was never a hard figure given. The only hard figure was the council voted $10,000, but realistically speaking, there isn't anybody in this world can hire law firms and not know what it's going to cost, and that's from the simplest thing, literally a step for fixing a traffic ticket or something like that. It just doesn't work that way in the legal world.
Is your understanding the same as mine, that the $10,000 set aside by the city council when the community voted to establish a charter commission, that the $10,000 set aside was seed money to start the process?
That's what's generally referred to as seed money in the start.
As our treasurer, do you recall us ever establishing a budget?
No. No, but I do recall this much in the minutes we'll show it, or the tapes or this and that, that I more than one time made mention of the fact, given the reports, that we would need more funds.
As a matter of fact, you told Mr. Estes when we first started, if I recall your conversation correctly, and I'm not trying to put words in your mouth, but if I recall what you told me before, you told Mr. Estes, this thing will probably cost $30,000, and that was the first 2 or 3 weeks that we were seeing.
That was off the top of, that was a, you know, an off the top
thing. And I've heard from other people that that's not an abnormality or an unreasonable expectation considering what attorneys
have. No, but I will say this. I'm not the other people's accountant or their attorneys or anything else. We wanted the best people in. There are people here in here who are complaining about the attorney fees. I don't think it's proper to, in view of the fact that they were the hardest pushers for the attorney.
Thank you, Mr.
And that's it. If there's any question, I'd be happy to try to answer them.
Mrs. Whitman.
I, along with everyone else in here that was present on the evening, that we took a vote on law firms. We were given three to choose from. Yes, Byron Cave seemed to be the most qualified. But I said right then and there, we need to be very, very, careful in our spending. We wait until we get an article completed before we bring in the attorney. I did not approve, nor did I expect, the attorney to have to be present at all of these meetings, including, I just see that the attorney was present for a period of 3 hours being charged going to Crossroads Chamber of Commerce. Now, I think it was a responsibility of the chairman to keep in touch with the law firm to know as to what expenses were being incurred and to have informed the law firm as to how much money we had to spend and to have contacted the city to ask for more money initially, which was not done.
Okay,
I did not approve monies of this nature being spent, nor the time having been spent on the part of the law firm.
Mrs. Whitman, you stayed on the drafting committee chairman, Bob Grissom, to get Jim Azure to stop doing the writing of the document. You welcomed in Wesley Fields, the attorney, to be at those drafting meetings?
I did not. I did not approve for us to have an attorney at each one of those meetings. That is wrong, very wrong.
I watched you. I was in some of those meetings and saw you. So you weren't, and then you also were the one to ask him at one point, probably 6 weeks ago or so, to ask him at one point what the bill was at, and he said $10,000. You had the heads up before I did.
And you did nothing to do. Just a minute. I had a lengthy discussion when I learned out how much money had been spent. I want to know how much of the $3,500 that we had given that law firm as a retainer had been spent. And I was shocked to hear that we had spent in excess of $10,000 in less than 3 weeks period of time. And we had a discussion that very afternoon with all of the members of the subcommittee about that type of expense having been incurred.
Okay. But you knew of it. Dan Estes, the finance director for the city of Raytown, had to know where that money was going and at what rate.
And you and had to know too, Mr. Lee Gray.
Yes, a question.
You did know.
No,
Who sent the bill?
Point of order, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Barnes.
Yeah, but let's keep the issue through the treasurer's report.
Well, I think maybe this partly is. All right, Mr. Griss.
I guess I have no recollection that the Charter Commission was ever told that we had only $10,000, there was $10,000 to be spent on the charter. Was that information ever relayed to the Charter Commission? I was never aware that was a...
According to Dan Estes, it was put in a memo at the bottom of a memo on a different subject on December the roughly 16th. And I reread that memo, which was emailed to me. And it is down there as the very last item, unrelated to anything else. And I don't know. I found that rather peculiar because I'm under the same impression Mr. Walters is, that I was always told just turn in the bills. Mr. Truesdale.
I guess the only thing I would say is from the beginning, I thought, I don't know, the first meeting, but close to the beginning, I thought we had been informed, I don't know whether it was through email, I don't recall it being at a meeting, but somewhere we were informed of a $10,000 budget. I don't know that anybody expected that was all the amount that we had. But I do recall we were asked to come to the board for more monies, or I thought that's what we were told to do, if we needed more.
I would have thought that since the finance director was our liaison, that he would have given me a heads up much, much sooner than he did on doing that. Mr. Asher.
Two things. One, in the very beginning, there was a budget committee appointed, though it never met. And there were members who were actually designated to be on that committee, and at least twice that I remember early in the meeting, people asked, when is the budget committee going to meet? And they had just never met. But that topic did arise because
I
think...
Do you recall why that was?
Well, no, that's not the point I'm trying to make. I think the point was that there were members of this committee that believed that we were going to follow a process where you try to create a budget and then take that to the Board of Aldermen. Now, I did at least on two occasions, one being the night that we hired the attorney that we did hire, tell the committee that yes, the board figured that it was going to may cost more than $10,000, but before that money could be allotted, they had to have a budget and take it to the board and ask for it. You couldn't spend it and then go to
it. You told the committee or the commission?
I told this commission.
Not the committee.
Okay, I'm sorry. I told the Charter Commission. Right.
All right. Mr. Greg Walters.
Yeah, I was just going to say, I remember clearly going back to the $10,000 the city initially put together for the budget purposes. It was just a placeholder. It was not ever intended to be, you're going to spend $10,000, stop. If that helps clear up anything as far as the city council goes, because I was on the finance committee when that was done. I may have set the amount. But to me, it's silly to go back and argue about stuff. It's like arguing over spilled milk. But I do know that what you were talking about, Ms. Drazier, about a committee being formed to do this, the issue came up upon the hiring of the city attorney. The entire commission was there. it's kind of silly to say, okay, the committee's going to meet now when you've got the whole commissioner is going to make the final decision anyway, so the whole commission met.
I do know, you know, it's interesting because I know that I'm pleased with what Mr. Fields has done, and I think I'm the only one here that voted against his firm, you know, hiring him. But the thing is, I don't see the point in where we're going with this discussion. You know, we're trying to point fingers. The work's been done. We got a bill to pay. Pay the bill.
Okay, thank you. Mrs. Whitman, final word?
It was shortly after the end of the month, on the 1st or the 2nd of August, that I asked Mr. Wesley Fields for the second time, how much money have we spent to this point? It wasn't until the 22nd of September that the discussion came up. We didn't have a treasurer's report on that date regarding how much money had been spent in legal fees, and I had to remind the commission as a whole that we knew that back around the 1st of August.
Okay, well, I saw in Dan Estes's report that he received the first and the second bill from the attorneys, and if it didn't raise a red flag with him, he didn't raise a red flag with me. If there's no further discussion, Mr. Al Walters, the treasurer, I'll let you have last word.
That's nice of you. But anyway, well, Ms. Whitman is right in that respect. However, what was told was this, that the attorney's firm, they had not even sent the billing out. There was absolutely no way of even that we would have known what the billing was at that time. I remember you did give us a figure. Mr. Wesley gave us a figure, and I remarked that I thought it was reasonable.
Yeah.
And that was just my opinion, of course, and everything, but it was pointed out that the document wasn't finished. And like I said earlier, when you get into legal things like this, it's kind of like, it's just like anything that's continuing. The costs are going to continue to do it.
Yeah. Well, I know we met in here for 5 hours one night, and you all had about a 3-hour or 2-hour meeting on Wednesday for the drafting committee. And I knew right then and there, and I'm no math wizard, but I knew there were $1,600 in bills that week alone for attorney fees. Is there a motion to accept the treasurer's report?
I so move.
Mr. Jameson moves. Second. Second, Mr. Greg Walters. Further discussion? There being none, roll call, please, Mr. Secretary.
Asia.
No.
Barnes, yes. Briggs.
Yes.
Darby, absent. Grissom, Gray pass. Grissom.
Yes.
Jameson.
Yes.
Mack, absent. Chiel, absent. Truesdale.
This is just to accept
the treasurer's report.
Yes.
Al Walters.
Yes.
Greg Walters.
Yes.
Whitman.
No.
Gray.
Yes. Public input? There being none?
I was just wondering.
Mr. Ertl, would you...
You're going to take apparently final approval on some changes you made in something. What version are you going to make changes to and approve tonight? I'm 3 or 4 at my house. I'm just wondering. Is this one you're working on?
Well, we're going to get to that in our agenda.
I just like to know. I have another question.
Go ahead. I'll try to field it.
When does this commission go out of existence?
This might be a good question for Mr. Fields.
Once the charter has been presented to the voters and voted upon, and then election certified by the Jackson County Board of
Election Day, more or less. All right.
Wait, no me.
No, we're just answering the question. You can take it back. Mr. Earl just asked when the commission went out of business, when you officially go out of business, and Wesley explained it.
That's great. You know, it may be never. At this rate, we may have lawsuits and be here for life.
I'm not going to be here for life.
Any further public input? Yes, ma'am.
I wasn't going to say anything, but as a citizen, I want to thank everybody for all the time and effort they put into this, even though I don't agree with you. I really appreciate the courtesy that a lot of you have shown me as a, just as a citizen.
Thank you. We appreciate hearing that.
We appreciate your attending.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's great. Just for the record, I appreciate the fact that we have held all of our meetings in a public forum, not going behind closed doors, and laws and stuff like that. Everything's been done here. And we have an abundance of candidates.
Yeah, we could have very easily had executive session tonight to discuss much of this, and we don't have anything to hide, so we're not in executive session. I'd like to turn this number one question over to our attorney, Wesley Fields of Bryan Cave, and let you explain to the Charter Commission and the public what it is we're doing here tonight.
Okay. I'm going to circulate resolution number three.
Confiscating also.
Send the rest of them down.
Yeah, copy yourself.
Yep.
Thank
you.
This is just a housekeeping question. I had some questions that I had prepared. I just want to follow your procedure that you choose to go by. And I wrote these out. I can give a copy to everybody. If Mr. Field is going to conduct this, you want me to give these to you now or wait or...
I would say that it would be most appropriate when we get into discussion that you bring them up.
Okay,
Mr. Fields has the floor. Mr. Fields has the floor at present, and he's going to explain to us what we're doing.
Okay, there are essentially six issues that are being placed before you this evening for your consideration of the form. Resolution number three. The first section's whereas clauses are just the recitals, essentially stating when this body was elected, when the election results were certified, the fact that resolutions 1 and 2 were signed by 9 of the 13 members of the Charter Commission and then submitted to the Johnson County Board of Elections. Also, this resolution states the desire of this Charter Commission to cause certain non-substantive modifications to be made to the Charter to clarify the intent of this Charter Commission. Also, for the Charter Commission desires that the City of Raytown to pay all of its expenses that are necessary to prepare, explain, present the Charter to the citizens of Raytown, Missouri, pursuant to the Missouri Constitution, Article 6, Section 19, and also that the Charter Commission would engage Bryan Cave, the representative, in connection with any litigation related to the Charter. As you know, there's been a lawsuit petition for filed by the Johnson County Board of Elections, I think last Friday. So you'll see at the bottom of the resolutions where it says, be it resolved by the Charter Commission first, that the Charter Commission hereby ratifies any previous demands made upon the city for payment of any of its unpaid expenses incurred that are necessary to prepare, explain, and present the Charter to the citizens of Raytown. Secondly, with respect to projected expenses, authorizes the chairman or his designee to make demand upon the City of Raytown for payment of any costs and expenses this Charter Commission shall incur that are necessary to prepare, explain, and present the Charter to the citizens of Raytown. Third, you'll see a ratification of certain modifications to the Charter. I have a charter here that references certain modifications that have been made, primarily typographical errors, non-substantive changes that have been made to the Charter since it was submitted to the Jackson County Board of Elections in September 23rd, 2005. I'll submit that in just a second. Fourth is the approval of an informational brochure that essentially explains the Charter and basically in a two-page format. It actually describes some of the modifications to the city government will be as a result of the Charter being passing. The Charter passing. And then fifth is the engagement of legal counsel to represent the Charter Commission in the existing litigation and independence circuit court. And then also section six is a broad authorization granted to the chairman or his designee. And you'll see I'm not going to read that entire section. But in other words, it's pursuant, it's giving him the ability to take whatever action to carry out the foregoing resolutions. So with that, I certainly would be happy to answer any questions about this resolution. We can certainly pass out a charter which reflects the modifications that have been made.
Wesley, does this charter printed that you're going to hand out reflect the one that was professionally printed in
Correct.
Booklet form?
Thank it does. You. It does.
Okay, I would note to you all, and if I could have attention, please, I would note that whereas the Charter Commission desires to cause certain non-substantive modifications to be made, that those changes were typographical errors, four of them, and one or two dropped lines of something we previously approved about residency of command staff for the police department, because we wanted our first responders that are in charge here. So there is not anything substantive changed in this charter from the time we all approved it. Okay, Mr. Fields?
I'm just happy to, here's I'm going to pass out this.
Okay. Anyone have any questions for Mr. Fields, Mr. Alwalters?
I want to make certain that I understand this correctly, and I'm sure I do. What we are in effect doing, we are hiring Mr. Fields as the Charter Commission to pursue collection of all bills due. Right?
Yes, sir.
That's okay. I don't want somebody to come back and say it was all tied up in a bunch of legalese.
And as far as I'm concerned, what we're doing tonight is something we've already done. In all respects, Ms. Whitman.
Could you tell me who has the money in this commission to pay the attorney's legal fees to represent this commission?
The city is obligated under the Constitution of Missouri to pay our necessary incurred expenses. But if you're asking personally, maybe it'd be me. Anyone else? Mr. Azier.
Mr. Fields, Section 6 authorizes the chairman, which I assume is Mr. Gray, prepare, execute, deliver, perform. Does that mean basically that he can, would you explain what that means exactly? Does that mean that he therefore can enter into contracts or initiate the activity of this committee or commission without going in front of the committee as a whole?
Not outside the scope of the foregoing resolutions.
Okay, so this basically has only to do with the legal expenses and nothing else?
It has to do with items 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Any further discussion?
Okay, can I ask a question still? I wasn't done yet. Does that include the lawsuit you've already filed?
We didn't file a lawsuit. We actually responded to litigation.
The city was served today on a lawsuit. They were told they were
the city was in court today on.
Excuse
a
me,
lawsuit.
I'm talking about something different. Before you went to court, the city was indeed informed that a suit had been filed against them by this committee to collect the expenses. Is that not correct?
No.
It was facts to the attorney's office. I saw the facts.
It did not happen that way.
No,
not to my knowledge.
Okay, that took place this morning, roughly about 9:45.
No, at 1:37.
Can you produce the document to show us?
This is not a question. I mean, that can be very easily proven because all facts have times and dates on them, okay? I'm not here. The question was, I'm not here to start an argument. I'm here to ask questions, okay? I ask a question, you start an argument, okay? I'm not here to do
that.
I just ask him. I told you what happened, you call me a liar. Which has happened the whole time, this whole committee.
Point of order, Mr. Chairman. Twice already.
Point of order, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Barnes.
We're not going to get into personal attacks.
Can you ask Mr. West a question? Mr. West
answered
the question.
Yes, that's it. No, we did not file a lawsuit.
The lawsuit that was in court today was brought by the Jackson County Election Board to clarify what the people are voting on. It was brought against the City of Raytown and the Raytown Charter Commission. And I sat there and watched the proceedings. They will be wound up at 1:30 Friday in Judge Grant's court, room 17 at the Independence Courthouse.
That was not what I was talking about.
Okay, thank you. All right, further discussion. There being none, the chair would entertain a motion.
I think,
okay, Mr. Grissom.
I'd like for Mr. Hager to explain what this lawsuit is.
Well, I was informed as a member of the board.
I'm gonna interrupt that because it's not germane to our discussion without proof that there is a lawsuit.
Well, but you said that the city had been sued about something. I guess I want to clarify.
It wasn't sued by the Charter Commission, right?
That's what I want.
I mean, we have no proof that there's a lawsuit. We have no documentation. And Mr. Fields has already told us it didn't come from us. So I see no reason to pursue discussion of that at this time. I'd like to stay on these resolutions. Now, Wesley, tell us exactly what it is you want us to do on either approving or rejection of these resolutions, or do we do them item by item, or is it just one package?
You can just do it in one package.
Okay. If that's going to be the case, which is fine with me because I don't want to spend the rest of my life here tonight, I would like to take the neutral piece, which has been handed to the city attorney, and it's been passed around. And I have a couple of questions.
Where is the neutral piece?
Greg, you produced this, right? Okay. And I sent you my ideas, and you wrote it and produced it. Okay?
Oh, yeah.
Now, explain to me the simplest part, and this is probably a printing issue. Why is this page upside down compared to the others?
Oh.
Is it way as it folds?
I probably turned it the other way because you're the second person to bring that up. Fold it in half.
Okay.
Okay. Fold the male side out. Okay. Now open it.
Okay.
No, that's not
the way you open
it.
Well, that's the way I open it.
I wouldn't open it that way. I would open it like that.
Oh, like
yeah,
this.
That's how I would open it.
Oh, okay.
But I'm beginning to think I may be wrong, or I'm just the only one that always thinks.
Dyslexic. Maybe you're just dyslexic. Mr. Al Walters, long time friend.
As a cost saving measure, if you tab something at the top, it only tabs once.
Right.
It has to tab twice at the bottom. That's why they're made that way. So they're wrong either way you look. Depends on how people. It's sort of like the roll of toilet tissue. Does it go this way or this way?
It goes over.
I can live with that. I just want an explanation. All right? Now, as far as this document is concerned, being neutral, the city attorney has a copy and is looking at it. It is hoped, as one of the associates of Mr. Field said to the city attorney today, that this can be approved at City Hall and doesn't go into court Friday. It's hoped we can stop all the silly game playing, in other words. Only thing I'm going to ask about a couple of issues here,
okay?
And the rest of you are free to track along with me. A charter for Raytown. My wording would have been a Raytown charter for consideration.
6.5 dozen of the other. I always try to condense.
Okay, but I'm the one that spent all the time in graduate school studying semantics, all right? So I'm going to be a little picky. Just tolerate me.
Remember, you got to write the way people speak.
Just tolerate me. Well, not all of us speak the same way. For example, a fourth-class city is commonly called a statutory city. That means that they may only enact laws.
All right, that's
it. Right. Okay. Again, reference approved for them. It. The city is an it. Following is a list changes that will be enacted. A list of changes. Okay?
Did you mark these?
Yes, I did.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Old proofreader here. And not a very good one most of the time. Very, very minor problem. 2-year moratorium needs a hyphenation for 2-year because it's a modifier. Okay, on the back. I didn't understand why the bold face in the areas where it said it is this document that you will be voting on Tuesday, and down another paragraph or so, a unique aspect of this ballot in addition to the charter question, you will also be asked to vote on 2 pullout issues. Now, it may just be in the reproduction that there is no boldface there because that can happen on a printer. But if it is boldface, I think it ought to all be regular type. And again, it could be my eyesight right here. See, that's boldfaced and this is boldfaced. And I would make
I felt that they were very strong points that are, number one, you're going to be voting on it.
Right.
And number two, the pullout issues, which are quite an anomaly.
But if it's going to be a neutral piece, then it has to have a neutral appearance.
I see what you're saying, but it's not meant as a selling.
Okay, I know, but I'm being picky, all right? I told you that before I started.
Well, that's the first one you said I disagree with. I also think it breaks up the copy, makes it easier to read.
All right. Third paragraph down, the purpose of this informational brochure is to spell out major changes. I do not believe the word major belongs in there because we made very few changes.
You're right.
This is not major. As a matter of fact, government reflects a lot of what we've got now. All right, proofreading down on the pullout issues. If the charter is approved, each pullout issue is approved. Issue, singular, okay? And I still question the use of www.raytownreporter.com /whatever for a neutral piece.
It's a dead end site. There's nothing else there. And the only reason, as I explained earlier, is because the city's site, if you use it, it's about that long on the address line. Okay. And if somebody wants to pay for, one that just says www.raytowncharter.org or whatever, that's fine with me.
Well, you and I discussed this earlier, and you said it was approved by our attorneys. If it's approved by the city attorney, it's a non-issue. Is there any further discussion?
Do you want those corrected? I understand city council meeting tomorrow night. I assume that's going to be brought up. I don't know.
Well, we still don't have an agreement with the city attorney. So,
if we're going to make those corrections, that's what they should look at, to be the corrected pieces.
Yeah, and I think if we're going to vote, we ought to just vote and get this all over with.
Right.
Mr. Attorney, would you agree?
Sure.
Do you have any comments on my pickiness?
No, I think it's fine.
Okay. I disagree.
We're in a world of nitpicking anyway. I'm going to just cut it out. Just have a good nitpicking party.
Well, I don't mean to be nitpicky, but I spent so many years as an editor and teaching college and stuff that these are little things that always jump out at me. Maybe that's just my own little picadillo. I'd entertain a motion for approval. The resolutions. Matter of fact, I'll go so far as to make it myself.
So,
what?
I haven't even gotten to look at it yet. Either Mr. Grissom.
What do you want to look at?
You want to look at this dummy they've got here.
Oh, right here.
I think it came out of your shop. You should know what's on it.
I don't see everything.
All right, you go ahead. I got to grab a drink of water. You can take over.
Okay. I just have to see Bob Phillips reads in the paper.
I believe where you're at.
Are we approving the neutral pieces with the resolution? Or we're going to approve?
You actually can. You can upsize the neutral pieces.
I mean, the thing to pay for is
in the same way the city pays for it.
So we approve resolution number 3. Our attorney says that we can just add that under section 4 where it says exhibit B, which is what we're passing around as modified, if you want to.
I think a colon up here under it. This charter provides 3 rights of petition. It would be better than that. What do you think, Mr. Gray?
Sir, I'm agreeable to almost anything at this point. Okay. Is there further discussion? There being none, the chair will make a motion to approve the resolutions.
Is there a second?
Is there a second?
Second.
Greg Walters, second.
Okay. Further discussion?
Is there any further discussion? There being none, chair call, roll call.
Okay, adoption of resolution number 3.
Asia?
No.
Barnes, yes. Briggs?
Yes.
Darby, absent. Grissom?
Yes.
Jameson?
Yes.
Mack, absent. Shield, absent. Truesdale?
No.
Al Walters?
Yes.
Greg Walters?
Yes.
Whitman?
No.
Gray?
Yes. Vote total, please.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 yeses. 1, 2,
three noes.
Yeah.
Two, three absences.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. There being no further business before the commission, I'll ask for a motion to adjourn and ask those of you who want to sign this resolution to please come up here and sign it and have it notarized.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes. Those who voted for it need to sign it.
Okay. I wanted to entertain a motion that we allow Mr. Gray to represent us for the city council on November 1st so there's no mistake.
Mr. Briggs, I appreciate your motion. We should have added that in our approval of the agenda, and since we didn't, I'm not going to allow your motion.
Okay, well, I hope the mayor will recognize you as coming from this group rather than as an individual. Of course, you've been so rude to you at the last meeting.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there a motion for adjournment? So moved, Mr. Walters.
I really have a question for the attorney.
Knock yourself out.
Would you mind telling us exactly what the status is now? There was a hearing in court today.
I am going to have to overrule that because, again, it's not on the agenda. And again, do you see how that fits into what we're discussing tonight?
We can talk about under four.
Under four? Okay, then go ahead. Excuse me. I'll take your word for it.
Sure. That's fine.
You want to know what happened today?
Well, I'd like to know what happened today and what the next steps are on this thing here. I hear so much talk about lawsuits. Jim told us about one here, and he said that the election board suing. I fully expect to get served by somebody by morning.
There was a petition filed by the Jackson County Board of Elections this past Friday, asking that the judge declare whether or not the charter that was being circulated by this commission, which had the non-substantive modifications made to it, was it different or did it not reflect the intent of the charter commission that was in the body of the document that was submitted and approved and certified by the Board of Elections on September 23rd. And at that hearing, which occurred today, at 12:30 in front of Judge Gray, he asked for both parties to come back essentially with briefs on particular issues, the first of which was whether or not the mandate by the Constitution, specifically Article 6, Section 19, required that this charter commission present a charter to the voters within 1 year from the date of their election, which was November 2nd, or whether it was from the date the election was certified, which was November 11th, or whether or not it just could occur in November pursuant to state statute in terms of what the election cycle is. That's one issue. We'd like to have both parties frame for him for his consideration. The second issue dealt with whether or not the city has standing to raise these issues with the judge. Do they have standing to bring a cause of action against the Charter Commission? Third issue was whether or not the modifications that were made to the document after September 23rd, 2005 were in fact still consistent with the intent of this body. And then whether or not what his authority is in terms of accepting those modifications to be presented to the voters of Raytown. Fourth issue will be part of this evidentiary hearing, which will occur on Friday, is to determine what are the necessary expenses of this charter commission to prepare, present, and explain a charter to the voters or the citizens of Raytown. So those are the issues that we've been asked to frame for the judge to consider. This Friday, I believe, at 1:30 is when the hearing is.
Thank you, Mr. Fields.
Sure.
The reason I ask is every time I've seen a legal entanglement, it seems to never get settled. So let's just say the judge rules one way. Now, what avenue, what can happen next?
It'll be, it can be appealed on either side.
To the state Supreme Court.
Right.
And then you get the thing, you get the thing on the ballot, the public votes and says yay or nay, and then they start all the new lawsuits. So, I mean, we've got to keep our friends in business. Motion to adjourn.
Mr. Gray, you was allowed to ask a question.
Yep.
I did have a list of questions prepared, but I'll just give you a copy of that. I would like you to just reply to me in writing. There's one question you directed toward Winston Fields, and probably only he could answer. I did send a letter to the Board of Aldermen telling them that this commission had authorized you to sue them. I received a copy of that letter. I just want to know who authorized that letter. Was that something that you did on your own, or did this this commission do it?
It wasn't a matter of suing. It was a demand for the outstanding expenses, and that was provided by your chairperson.
At the very end of it, it did say, or there would be a lawsuit initiated.
No, we didn't say that. It didn't say a lawsuit would be initiated.
It never mentioned a lawsuit, did it?
Didn't mention a lawsuit.
Okay. Motion for adjournment. Thank you, Mr. Grissom. Second, Mr. Briggs. All those favor, yay?
Yay.
All those opposed, nay? So moved.
You have to sign the document.